Okay, this is Julie Christie, and I just wanted to begin this by, I don't mean to turn off the volume all the way on that, by the way, with the song Vulindlela, which is by a South African artist called Brenda Fassie, and it means open the way or open the gates. And I began the video by just sharing some footage of my room, soon to be my bedroom and creative space, my workspace. It was cluttered. It still is cluttered, but it's on its way to getting ready for me to use, because it is time. It is time for me to open the way so I can become the Julie Christie of the future, Julie Christie 4.0, my realized self. And I can't do that with all this baggage, with all this junk, this stuff that's just, you know, surrounding me. And some more over there, you know. And this room was just chocker, absolutely chocker. And it's time to let it go. And I'm letting it go with the mindset of opening the way. Open the way so I can become, open the way so I can receive everything I need to become my ultimate self, the highest expression of myself. And I just thank God for everything and how things are working out, because through House of Her, the coaching academy that I'm a part of, you know, there's stories of the ladies who I'm running alongside in this 90-day run. Oh, by the way, this is day 11 in the 90-day run. And, you know, they're doing the same similar things. You know, one lady cleared out her old clothes and from her wardrobe recently, all before work. She couldn't sleep, and instead of going on her phone or social media or something, she got up, she dealt with some stuff, got rid of the old to make way for the new. And another lady, she's looking to make room for a partner, a life partner. And her task for this week, which we're holding her accountable for in our group, is to, you know, clear her space, her whole house. And I never set out to do this week at all. But today, it just, the pieces fell into place for me. I know I've been needing to do it. This clutter needs to go. And I said it a while ago that I'd move into this room. It's actually our lounge downstairs, which we use as a guest room because we've got a fold up at dinner. But my desk is here. I've identified a long time with this is an ideal workspace. And so now for me, you know, I've talked about it and it's time to do it. So I pushed, I started around 5 or so. It's almost midnight. It's time to get it done. It is time. You know, my life has been reset. I know this. But you know what? The realization didn't trickle down to my day-to-day. And the fact that, you know, if you're starting a new life, you need to start anew. You know, you need to let go of the old. And so for me, that is really my message for today. My growth, letting go of the old. And it's helped me, because letting go of all the clutter. I mean, the stuff that's actually on this chair is stuff that I'm keeping. I've decided from all the stuff that was on the floor and around the room, that's the stuff that can stay. I'm not yet figured out where it's going to go, but I need to let go of the old. So I've let go. There's a lot of papers from the past that I've said goodbye to that I didn't even remember were there, but clearly they're taking up space. And although this is phase one, I've just cleared behind my desk, which is here, so I can push the desk back against the wall and actually get the bed out and ready for use. This is phase one, because I've got to get in that cupboard here. And I have no idea how, oh my gosh, there's so much stuff in there. Honestly, there's so much. But I've got to make it work. And yeah, there was no day 10 update yesterday, but that message was simply this. I'm up leveling all the areas of my life. And so it's not just my personal growth that's getting the boost. It's my home life. It's my relationships. It's parenting, the love relationship, everything. And just looking at how can I improve things. And another significant thing actually is the 5 senses. In my coaching class this Sunday, Coach Laura Lyles was encouraging us to have new experiences, look at what new things can we afford ourselves through our five senses? So sight, sound, touch, taste, smell. And I really identified this as a really cool opportunity for me to get to know myself. And I'm off to a rocking start. I mean, in our accountability group call yesterday, I decided that I'd take the week basically to look at, you know, each one of those and basically uncover what do I like? What do I want for each of those things? Like, what clothes do I like and want? And what do I like about myself, my physical appearance? Food, you know, what foods do I like to eat? What foods do I want to eat? And it's just blown me away, really, because, I mean, yesterday I tackled taste, you know, my foods. Today I tackled my clothes, done and dusted. I started tackling sounds, like, what do I like to hear? What kind of music? And, you know, it's music like the song I was just playing earlier, Vulindlela by Brenda Fassie. You know, it's stuff that inspires me, you know, music that speaks to me, builds me up, encourages me along my way. And this song, for the moment I'm in right now, is perfect. Open the way. You know, this is what I'm doing by decluttering. This isn't just clearing out stuff, right? I want to live in a minimalist home. That's the ideal for me. But it's more than that. This is making the way for the new by letting go of the old. So yeah, that is day 10 and 11 of my 90-day run. And yeah, thank you.